In terms of the Defence Act 2002, Act 1 of 2002, Section 14, Subsection 1, empowers the Minister of Defence to do or cause to be done all things which are necessary for the efficient defence and protection of Namibia or any part thereof. Subsection 2 of Section 14 of the Defence Act further empowers the Minister of Defence, inter alia, to acquire, hire, construct, and maintain defence works, ranges, buildings, training areas, and the land required for defence purposes. At independence, all the facilities which were established for defence purposes were inherited by the Minister of Defence. This included the military bases, training areas, ranges, and entertainment facilities. The Minister of Defence is aware that not all facilities were transferred to its name, as some were illegally alienated to individuals. These include houses, ranges, and farms. The existing facilities are, however, not sufficient. Hence, the Minister of Defence has to resort to acquiring more land to fill that void. This is why farms Etiro and Oropoko were purchased. The MOD, that is the Minister of Defence, has a mandate to guarantee defence of our national sovereignty. This, the Minister of Defence, does through the provision of the necessary resources to the Namibian Defence Force. These resources include people, military and other equipment, and infrastructure. The Namibian Defence Force is expected to be operationally ready and effective at all times. To achieve this standard, the Namibian Defence Force members have to undergo training regularly to master their equipment and gel in order to fight together as one unit when the need arises. Battles are mostly fought in vast spaces to allow the fighting troops to apply the necessary tactics and maneuvers in order to have advantage over their adversaries. In preparation for war, therefore, soldiers have to train the way they are intending to fight. Thus, their training exercises must be conducted on vast land called training areas. At the moment, we have training areas and shooting ranges at Oserekari, Ulunga Wakolondo, Oshivero, Ochiwarongo, Mpacha, Otavi, Kietmaswo, Swatkopis, Ruikop, Luipers Valley, Karibib, just to mention a few of those areas that belong to the Minister of Defence and the NDF. Thus, communities and the public should be aware that those areas cannot be inhabited and are training grounds for the soldiers. It must therefore be understood very well that the farmlands acquired by the Minister of Defence are not meant for farming at all, but for defence purposes. In the past, we have allowed communal farmers to graze their animals in our training areas. However, we have come to regret that decision. Our training areas at Oserekari and Osibero have now been invaded by communal farmers who have even erected permanent structures on that land. The presence of the farmers in our training areas is inhibiting our training activities, and action will be taken very soon against those farmers. On the invasion of Farm Etiro, the invasion of Farm Etiro started way back in March of 2019. Understanding the drought situation, we remained lenient towards those that trespassed by allowing them to graze their cattle at a very small scale. We then undertook to strengthen the fence to prevent the escalation of invasions. While the fence was being strengthened, more farmers arrived and infiltrated their cattle into the farm at night. The population of cattle in the farm swelled over 1,000 head of cattle. And there were over 30 crops adjacent to a Etiro farm. It was then at that point we decided to instruct the farmers to stop trespassing on the Minister of Defense property by removing their cattle. They removed their cattle, but still remained camping in the corridors. Whilst there, they would then cut the fence and kept infiltrating their cattle into the property at night. In the mornings, the troops would have or would drive the cattle out of the farm and still again fix the fence. This cat and mouse game became unbearable, and the arrival at the scene by Honorable McHenry Venaani aggravated the matter, as during the night of that very day, the fence was again cut and the cattle driven into the property. Honorable Venani's behavior and threats directed towards our National Defense Force members who were at their property and doing what they have been ordered to do by their superiors was uncalled for, childish, unacceptable, and cannot be tolerated by any peace-loving Namibian. I must emphasize this one. Mr. Venaani took it upon himself, and he was even wagging his fingers in the face of soldiers, telling them that he is not their equals. The question is, what was he doing there? If those soldiers, those members, were not his equals, what was he doing there in the first place, speaking to people who are not his equals? So such a kind of behaviors cannot be tolerated, especially if it's directed at the members of the Namibian Defense Force. The Defense Act prohibits illegal access to military premises in terms of Section 26 and provides for punitive actions. Section 26, subsection 1, provides that the minister may, by order issued under the minister's hand and published in the Gazette or made known in any other manner which the minister considers sufficient in the circumstances, prohibit or restrict the access of any person or category of person to any military camp, barracks, dockyard, installations, or other premises, or any land or area of water used for military or defense purposes, or which is under the military control. In violation of the prohibition or restriction stated, Section 26, subsection 3, provides that such a person commits an offense and is liable on conviction to a fine not exceeding $60,000 or to imprisonment for a period not exceeding 15 years or to both such fines and such imprisonment. There was therefore nothing wrong, and still there's nothing wrong, in prohibiting the communal farmers not to graze their cattle illegally in farm at